kids, you're about to listen to a comedy podcast. That means that none of this is medical advice. If you need medical advice and medical care, please contact your doctor. I'm Crampy Koala with Koala Cola. Tastes just like Down Under. Take it away, DJ Dylan.
Welcome to the Jock Doc Podcast featuring Dr. London Smith. As some of you may have heard, we have officially left the Casey Anthony Podcast Network. To Casey and the rest of the network, hey, we had a heck of a run. And though it's time for us to go our separate ways, trust, we will always remember you.
Hello, and welcome to the Jock Doc Podcast, where we discuss fitness and health, and how to incorporate our modern understanding of science and medicine into our daily lives, but without it being so boring. I'm your host, DrLondonSmith.com. I would like to begin by apologizing to our listeners. We've received some feedback about the excessive amount of technical medical terms that I've been using, such as pronator drift and over yonder. So I will try to temper my terminology to a simpler one in the future. Here to help with that is our producer, Cameron.
Hey, Dr. London, this is a very, very exciting episode. I don't know, you didn't announce it at the very beginning, but
yeah.
I mean, this is our very first live episode.
Yeah,
this not like live in front of a studio audience, but live as in if you're the podcast listener, this is happening right now.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it's not, you'll notice it's not on any of the normal streaming apps.
Yeah.
That you're familiar with. This is a new
Hopefully my tech has worked out where it's just sort of popped up on your phone and you're sort of figuring out what's going on right now. But this is a podcast very heavily influenced by that one ER episode where they did it live. The person listening went back 15 seconds.
Okay.
Let's go back 15 seconds.
Here to help with that is our producer, Cameron.
Hey, Dr. London. Nope, he paused.
Okay.
I guess we can just hang out for a second.
Yeah, do we? Okay.
Another person started listening.
Do we? Should I
keep talking? Who just started listening? Okay. Let's hold on 1 second. Person who just started listening, we're gonna get to you in just a second. Okay. The first person resumed. The second person has now.
Should I keep talking the whole time and then you?
The second person has left. He is listening to the Ben Shapiro show now. Which is, why is anyone in our audience?
There's a lot of crossover.
That's very annoying. Okay, and then now, okay, we have a third listener, and he skipped to the middle. Well, okay. Rewind back. All users are now back at the beginning.
Okay, maybe we should have used one of the mainstream streaming, apps.
But I wanted to do live podcasting, Dr. London. No one has truly done that before. It's not Twitch. It's not anything like that. It is its own thing.
I know, but
someone just went back 30 seconds, so we gotta go. If you go back 30 seconds,
okay. I'm assuming millions of listeners that Cameron managed to hack into your phones. But so Cameron, this, you know that on any of those streaming apps, they don't allow you to skip around or pause without going over old material.
They all paused. Every single user who was listening to the podcast just paused it right now.
Okay.
A lot of them seem to be switching to a Marc Maron episode where he talks to a guy from the Shins. That is not. I mean, that's beating us.
Yeah. I can see why it's beating us at this moment. Yes.
Okay.
Right
and then,
now.
Okay. And everyone has jumped ahead 15 seconds. So go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. Also with us is Digital in the House.
Digital in the House.
This is a very, very exciting episode. This is our very first live episode. If you're the podcast listener, this is happening right now. No one has truly done that before. It's not Twitch. This is happening right now. It's not Twitch.
Digital in the House.
It's not Twitch.
Digital in the House. house.
It's not Twitch. It's not Twitch.
Later, Cameron tells me we can expect some special guests. Is that right?
That's right, Dr. London.
Okay, great. Before we move on, I would like to address a bit of listener feedback. So this note comes from a formerly dissenting and no longer talkative machine worker in the Ocean Drudgers subdivision of the Coca-Cola Corporation's offshore fantastic drilling expedition. The note reads, quote, "I miss land and people," end quote. So, first of all, thank you so much for reaching out to us. So, I'm not an extrovert, but I do understand missing people. In my experience, whether you're waterbed drudging or anything else, all you have to do is walk out of the stream and talk to the people on land. So, after... So the note did say that they were formerly dissenting.
Well, I mean, the note is just a listener reaching out and saying, "I miss land and people."
Yeah. Yeah.
But so we don't know
the context.
Like, we don't really know the context of that. Like, are they, I mean, when they say people, are they talking about a specific person or are they talking about us?
Yeah. So if they miss us,
because no offense, like it would really suck if someone like put out that note. And again, no offense, and was like, "Oh man, I really miss seeing people." And then the first person they see is like you. And I'm not saying that's like you would be the worst person to see, but like you know what I mean.
What do you mean? Could you
like if you're in a situation where you are missing land and missing people, and then you finally reach it.
And I'm
wouldn't
the
it
one.
Be kind of disappointing if the guy you finally see is you? Yeah.
Okay. No, I guess because I get to see myself so often, I can see how it'd be disappointing to see me for me because that's very normal for me. That's common for me. So maybe for someone else, that kind of experience is replicated in a way.
It would be like, you know, being excited to finally find land again, and it's like Kansas City, and you're like, oh, okay.
Okay. Well, anyway, so to this listener, after you serve out your sentence or contract or whatever it is, I'm sure that your terrestrial buddies will be happy to see you again, and hopefully they aren't a disappointing person. Thank you for listening. Now for today's medical topic, hepatitis B. Hepatitis B virus is a double-stranded DNA virus that causes hepatitis B, which is one of the main causes of acute hepatitis. And hepatitis is, of course, you know, liver inflammation. So hepatitis B can be acquired through sex, through blood, through perinatal means, or parenteral exchange. Like all forms of acute hepatitis, hepatitis B can present with jaundice and dark urine. You can have fever, weight loss, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and hepatosplenomegaly. And of course, hepatosplenomegaly is when the liver and the spleen are enlarged. When you run diagnostic tests, it can show...
Why do you say you go like, of course? If of course people already know, then what is the point of any of this?
Yeah, I get... So,
I know that finding like a blog that's like doctorsnotes.com and then just reading off of it is a huge part of your sort of job.
Yeah.
But like if you're like, oh yeah, of course that you know that this is like a swelling of the liver. Then who are we talking to? I'm not interested.
Yeah, well, we're talking to the medical students here. That's
right. And for those of us who have already finished medical school like myself,
yeah, well, you at least swore the oath, which was, for you, the biggest part.
Yeah.
The hypocrite
the
oath.
The QAnon oath.
I mean, honestly, I call it the hypocrite oath. You call it the QAnon oath. It's it doesn't amount to much medical in my mind, but you know,
I don't know, man.
We swore different oaths. I think that much we can say. In any case, when you run the diagnostic tests, it can show increased direct bilirubin, increased ratio of ALT to AST on liver function tests, and increased alkaline phosphatase. In terms of diagnosing hepatitis B specifically, it's important to be able to interpret the serologic patterns. And so this one, for all you medical students, this is testing material. So a positive...
Well, now you're just ostracizing a gigantic part of our listenership, Dr. London.
Okay, and I should clarify...
You're saying
anyone.
This is only for medical students. Anyone who's not a medical student is an idiot. That's what you just said. And then you said, if you're listening to this and you're not a medical student, you go walk in the street. You just said that.
I feel like... Yeah, so I should clarify. This is...
Okay.
So to some extent, it is directed towards medical students, okay, for tests. But it's also directed towards anyone who... could have hepatitis B and would like to know what those results mean. Whenever they look at their own laboratory results, the doctor talks, but if they want to hear from a doctor they trust, like myself, this is this is another approach. So listen to your primary doctor, of course, and this is more supplemental learning.
And here's another message for you medical students. Maybe get a different kind of degree. Maybe go for something else. Maybe something that you can actually get a job with. Like an art history teacher or like a producer or just, you know, one of these like schools that has a guaranteed job for you on the other end.
Economic degree.
Yeah, like not a doctor.
Yeah. Okay. So in any case, a positive E antigen for hepatitis B indicates an acute or chronic infection. A positive hepatitis B core IgM antibody indicates either an acute infection, a chronic infection, or the window period. The hepatitis B core IgG antibody indicates the window period of an infection or a resolved past infection. The hepatitis surface antibody indicates either a resolved past infection, if the hepatitis B IgG antibody is also present, or it indicates vaccination if the hepatitis...
Majoring in music theory is a good idea.
Yeah. So it can... vaccination is indicated if the... hepatitis core IgG antibody is not present, but they do have the surface antibody. In other words, the surface antibody indicates whether someone has already acquired decent immunity to hepatitis B, whether through having had the infection or through vaccination. Does that make sense?
And stop what you're doing. Quit medical school. Pick your major as sketch writing and then minoring in, hanging out or something like cool, because you want a cool minor, because that's where like the cool people are going to be. You're going to meet them.
Yes.
Yeah. What majors? Yeah. I feel like
astronaut.
Yeah.
So if you major in, what did I say? Partying? Oh, no. Music theory.
Engineering.
And then you're minoring in
stuff
and,
you
like,
can't get a job in.
Shit, you're going to actually get a job as opposed to just majoring in like reading Wikipedia articles about doctor stuff.
Yeah. You've told a lot of engineers, lawyers, you told them to go off that path because it's not really, there's no job market out there for it.
Well, and there are more sketch shows today than there ever have been in the history of humankind. And that is my doing, Dr. London.
Because you've encouraged so many professionals to leave their profession.
So they are all former businessmen and, you know, former lawyers and stuff like that. Yep.
Okay, so it's important to test for the presence of hepatitis B surface antigen before initiating certain medications in a patient, because the medications will inhibit part of the immune system that would normally suppress hepatitis B growth. So such medications that suppress these critical aspects of the immune system include anti-CD20 medications such as rituximab, ofatumumab, obinutuzumab, as well as anti-CD52 medications like alemtuzumab and HIV pre-exposure prophylaxis such as tenofovir and emtricitabine. They can reactivate hepatitis B when used in the short term and then stopped. So And diagnosing hepatitis B, the level of viral particles should be tracked. PCR is used to measure the DNA of hepatitis B. Although the PCR viral load level is not the right test for the initial diagnosis of this infection, it is the right test for determining the if the treatment has been successful. So elevated viral load indicates or identifies the most accurate way to assess the degree of infectivity of the source patient. So basically, it assesses who is most likely to transmit their infection to their, you know, their baby or their sex partner or via needle stick. Yeah.
Right. And if you can, if you could major in, I don't know if you can do this, but if you could major in model UN management, I would say do that, because that's going to offer way more jobs than anything Dr. London's talking about. You know how like a lot of people will say like, oh, I do like hospital management or like hotel management or something like that as a career choice. This is, this would be for structuring out model UNs.
Yeah. Okay. Like for, is that an elementary school?
That would
school
be like a
more?
Minimum. Yeah. Like a six figure. You're talking entry school? Level pay grade, high school. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. But entry level, but you're saying there's, once you climb up the ladder, there's got to be
yeah,
a bigger...
then you start making, yeah, the real bucks.
Yeah. So hepatitis B becomes chronic in 10% of patients, and there's no treatment to prevent this, which is a big reason why we vaccinate for hepatitis B. So medicine, I think medicine's a pretty good field, just you might, you know, as opposed to the model.
Yeah, or like dog breeding. Like if you could major in puppy milling, I feel like that was going to be a lot more lucrative than anything medical.
Yeah. So, and this is just for money making opportunities, you're saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
and actually feeling like you made a difference in this world.
Okay. Okay. Well, you know, if that's all right, I think I'm done here. We can move on from there. All right, Cameron, you said that we have some guests today. Is that right?
That's right, Dr. And paused. The listener paused again. So I guess we can just, let's say for 5 seconds, let's just hang out.
Yeah, okay. So what
is that?
What are your,
why is your hair like that today?
What, the middle part?
Yeah. Who told you that was a good idea?
Well, so there's this like this new medical student who's been hanging around, and he
and they started resuming again. Go 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 go.
Okay,
go, go, go,
and
go, go,
they is this part of the okay? You said that it's your line. You what something about the guests?
The guests, welcome, guests. We have guests today.
Yeah, that's what I was asking you. Okay, then you said okay. Hello there. My name is Dr. Lennon Smith.com, and this is our producer Cameron. What were your names?
I'm Kyler. It's just one name.
Oh. You must be very important, right?
Yeah. Me and my friend Tanaca co-authored a book about how technology is affecting people's health.
Yeah, dude. It's pretty scary stuff.
Yeah, I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it. So is it just released? Have you been doing the interview lines, you know, with all the health podcasts?
Oh, no. Like, this podcast thing already kind of freaks me out. Like, Yep. Like airwaves, like, you guys were talking about pausing and stuff, and I'm like, dude, like, somebody could literally pause this right now? That's crazy.
Yeah, I should say, like, that's very atypical for podcasts. Don't let that turn you off from podcasts, because that's,
all right.
It's very unusual for the, performers, for the instructors to be...
Well, are you saying that you're sort of adverse to the technology aspect in general?
Oh yeah, dude. Like this technology is the bane of my existence. You know what I mean? Like it's, man. It you get goosebumps. I just get like hives talking about this.
Yeah.
So messed up.
Oh, just talking about it. Not from technology, but from talking about you get hives.
Yo, man, like. Technology is just ruining the world, and
wow,
I got to use it to stop it. It sucks.
That's actually chapter 5 of her book about how even talking about technology can give you hives.
Wow. That's a full chapter covers the fact,
mm-hmm.
And I guess it's established fact for you at least that just talking about it can give you hives. Have you thought of how maybe like it's it's your own personal stress levels that, you know, maybe cause some form of, you know, like it causes the hives as opposed to...
Dr. Lennon, that seems like you're blaming the patient for their ailments. Who would do that?
Yeah, patient blaming is so not cool.
It's not what I expected when I came here. I thought, you know... Okay.
No, I'm sorry. I was just trying to introduce a possible alternative. But, you know, keep telling it. So what's
your... I really want to know. I'm kind of worried right now because, like, I mean, I've got technology all in my house. I have a computer. I wake up in the morning with my Bluetooth headset. Like, I'm doing sales and sales and sales, and I keep doing all these sales every day. And am I killing my brain? And am I hurting my sales?
Well, first of all, what are you selling? That's very important.
Keyboards, right?
That's usually just whatever's in kind of like reach.
Well, I was going to say, he keeps technology everywhere, including keyboards under your shirt has been your latest thing, tucked into your pants.
Yeah, and you're talking about musical keyboards, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's better. Like, if we're talking about computer keyboards, then I would have just said your situation's terminal.
I would say, because...
Oh, no.
Because it is...
No, but
I feel like they are computer keyboards that you just use the clacking to use musical, right?
Well, no, yeah, I mean, it's a computer keyboard, and I use it to play. There's like a DDR emulator called Stepmania, mm-hmm. and I do that most.
Whoa, these words, man. One technological word at a time in a sentence, please.
Well, hi.
I want some details. Like, what is this tech doing to me? Am I dying? What's happening?
So, yeah, like, if you just, like, use a lot of technology, like, your eyes will, like, hurt a lot. That's why I'm wearing glasses right now, because it, like, protects me from, like, the vibrations coming out of the computer. And, like, a lot of, like, I'm, like, Gen Z, you know what I mean? Like, or Gen Z, wherever you're from. And, like, Gen Z people are just, like, used to being around technology. So this book is, like, to help older people to, like, you know what they're doing.
So, Jen...
Oh, so you're immune to the sort of, like, physical responses to technology is what you're saying.
Part of it, yeah, because I was, like, born when there was, like, 5G coming out of everywhere.
Like 2010?
Oh, man. Yeah, so Kyler is a indispensable partner of mine because he touches all the technology. Like,
yeah.
I dictate. He writes down on his iPhone or whatever, you know. It sounds
like Kyler is about 11 years old. Is that about right? Because if you were born at the invention of 5G and you guys have partnered up.
I was.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet?
It was analog. Mm-hmm. It was none of this digital.
Oh, you met, you know, analog. Okay.
Met analog. Like I was protesting in front of a Best Buy. You know, Friday.
For the listener, so analog is another word, I think, for in person.
I think, in this context. It's saying in the non-digital way, like people
yeah,
so
non-digital. Non-digital, yeah. Real, you know? Like, the first thing we did was high five. Because I was like, taking these people's PS5s and, like, just throwing them on the ground. And Kyler picked one up and was like, is this free? And I'm like, well, I took it and threw it away. And it was like, dope, or whatever word you used. And yeah. I don't know, like, he said he was going to, like, destroy some noobs or whatever. And that felt real, like he's going to destroy this game or something. And I was like, this guy knows my vision, even though he's young.
Yeah. I was going to just...
So this happened... This happened this most recent Black Friday. So you guys met and then wrote this entire book in the last like 4 or 5 months. That's awesome.
Yeah, we have had a lot of time with this pandemic, you know?
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I never fully addressed it. I was born in China and they had 5G like in 2005. So I'm like 15.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Don't worry. Oh, okay.
I was worried, yeah. And if we could address one thing that we kind of breezed over there, Kyler, did you say, what word did you say there? Cause I, you know, Ty said that you said some word, possibly, but maybe another word when at the drop of the PS5. I just want to clarify this. Was it great or dang it or shucks? And I'm sorry, all these profanities. I'm sure there'll be...
Yeah.
What did you say?
Oh, I said I was going to go, like, you know, destroy some bots.
Okay, it was a lot longer because it was
right.
A one word thing.
Technology. Yes. See, there you go. Okay. Like destroying robots. Yeah. See, like that's exactly like he gets me.
Yeah, that's trippy as hell, I gotta admit. So, what does the book teach? I guess I'm still not clear. Like you have this entire book about the dangers of technology, but what are they? They're hives.
Chapter five.
And
we have. We have the books here. We have copies here, each of us. So if we want
I haven't actually seen it. Like, I've just been dictating it, and I've been letting Kyler do everything. Yeah. So
he can't
like,
actually type. Yeah.
Oh, no.
So it's not even typewriter. It's just no.
It's just voice to text with Kyler's tech brain.
Right. I love the embroidery, first of all.
Thank you.
Oh.
On the cover.
Pages. Sweet.
Yeah. So this is kind of a big book. I'm impressed, really.
Yeah. And it looks like you guys autographed every single page in it. Which is cool. I mean, I think that's valuable. That's cool.
Well, it saves you trouble at book signings.
Yeah. Yeah, like I was blindfolded because I didn't want to see, you know, typed on page. That's some Gutenberg tech, you know. That's the work of the devil.
Yeah. Would you consider like a pulley system like they used to build the pyramids? Is that technology as well?
Oh, simple machines are totally within ballpark.
Okay.
Like joints, animals, all simple machines. So, you know, if animals use it, I'm dope.
Okay.
So, Ty, are you, and I hate to change the subject from the book here, but like now I'm realizing, are you some sort of, you know, Amish or one of those communities that, you know, really doesn't use a lot of technology? Or
what is that? What is Amish?
Okay.
There are a group of people who when they turn 18, they go on Rumspringa and they get a reality show in 2011.
Okay, that sounds a little too technologically advanced to me.
Yeah.
These Amish people should read this book because reality TV.
They're obsessed with tech. Yeah,
that's messed up, man.
Okay, well that's good to know for our. I'm sure our many Amish listeners.
Well, I mean, I'm looking through just some of the chapter titles here. This one it says chapter two, Tinder will end her. What does that mean? Assume it's saying that Tinder is going to, again, give you hives and kill you, but I would love some elaboration.
Yeah. Well, first of all, apologies for choosing a gendered pronoun, but it just, like, had to rhyme. And, you know, meeting people through the internet is dangerous. You know, that's why I'm Gen Z or Gen Z, and it just... You know, even I wouldn't dare to do that. Some people online do catfishing. Have you heard of catfishing?
Yes.
Whoa.
Yeah, you go out to the lake and you just sort of cast your
line. Oh my gosh.
No, it's when you put the bait on your arm and you do the whole.
Oh, in the hole.
Yeah.
Trying to catch him with your hand.
Okay, so clearly you haven't read our book because we talk about how catfishing is when someone disguises themselves as someone else on the internet. So like, you could pretend to be like a 5-year-old girl, even though you're a 30-year-old man. That's catfishing.
Yeah, it's real messed up stuff.
So like the advantage there would be like you get to feel young again. You get to kind of feel innocent. You get to.
But hold on a second. If that's catfishing, this wouldn't apply to say, 30-something podcast producer who online is pretending to be Zach Braff, right? That's fine, right?
So
right?
that's like
right?
more fine, but it's also bad because you're impersonating
someone.
It's also you're getting older because Zach Braff is more than 30.
Yeah.
So that's kind of appreciating the process of time and age, which kind of dope, you know?
So I guess I'm getting an endorsement to continue doing this from Ty, which is awesome. That's great.
Yeah, go for it. Like, the older you are, okay, the more analog you are. And the more analog you are, you're more my homie.
Okay. So even if he's pretending to... Okay. I guess I follow. Okay, yeah. So
I think maybe what Ty is saying is maybe let's take this offline, start pretending to be Zach Braff in real life.
Yeah. If you happen to be younger than Zach Braff, I think that's a productive way to spend an evening, unlike these Gen Z people with their tiki talkies and
TikTok.
The Ricky tiki talkies, yeah.
TikTok.
The house club.
Yeah.
I don't know, like this tech crap, you know.
So I've been on House Club, and I've noticed recently how I went to this dating one, and people were on it, and the title of it was like "Shoot Your Shot," and then I kept, this is kind of me asking for advice for how to use it, because you know a number of us did the "Shoot Your Shot" thing, which is you say, you know, I'm DrLondonSmith.com, I'm the host of the Jock Talk podcast, and Samantha, I'm interested in you. And then what I loved about it was that everyone who did that and courageously, you know, stepped up, got zero response. People would leave the chat. And I thought
that's pretty real.
Yeah,
that's
that was
pretty
really
realistic. That's what happens to me when I'm in my shower and I just have imaginary friends. That's an analog. Maybe this house club thing is pretty good. It simulates what it is to be in real life.
I'm sorry. So you in real life in the shower, you're imagining your friends, and then when you say like let's get together, let's hang out, they leave.
Yeah, like I'll be like Samantha, and I'm like, every time I've spoken to a girl and I said just their name, like what do? They just kind of give me like what, and I've never, you know, experienced anything after that. So like I'm like, well, realistically, in my shower dream, I'm like, I only know what I know. So they just leave.
And you're...
Wow.
And your shower dream... So do you wake up later? You said daydream first, and now I'm hearing just regular dream. Do you pass out in the shower?
Yeah, I think, like, you know, I was thinking about what's the earliest memory I could feasibly have, and... It's like, you know, because all I could really work with is my life history, and the earliest memory I could feasibly have is being in my mom. What kind of place is that? Warm, just water everywhere.
And then you...
So I just like sleep in the shower sometimes. It's fun.
You should put that on TikTok.
Okay, so that's a regular...
I'm just gonna throw this out there, but Ty, if you're falling asleep in the shower and also getting random hives, you might be sick. I'm just gonna throw that out there. There's no judgment here.
Are you blaming the patient too, bro?
Patient blaming.
Hey man, that is a good point. I apologize. I take that back. It was rude of me to even throw that out there. I just, you know. Just looking out for my guests.
It's one of those things when, you know, it's good to consider multiple possibilities. Even if you rule those out, it's good to consider it, at least for a moment, in my experience at least.
All right. Considered and shut down.
Okay.
Wow.
I
love the confidence.
Can I ask a question?
Which one?
Yes. So, yes. Doctor, your name's DrLondonSmith.com. So you're
That's
like
right.
a whole website.
Yeah, I'm like a whole website.
So,
yeah.
Like, I'm very concerned about your health because you're basically, like, merged into technology, and I'm afraid that's going to, like, damage your retinas.
So, yeah, so my ancestors were websites, my forefathers, and that's kind of like, I don't know, I did the Ancestry.com thing, and yeah, it turns out we are all websites going way back, so, I don't know that that's bad. I think that's just part of my cultural heritage. And I get that you guys are, you know, sort of anti-technology. But when
he's saying it's going to affect your retinas. Have you felt anything weird about your eyes as you've gotten older? Can you see as well as you did, honestly, when you were younger?
Especially, after. No, I have had to get corrective lenses.
There you go.
Wow.
There you go.
No.
So I didn't make Dr. that connection.
It's already
some cultures.
You. It's already
some
started.
Cultures are more predisposed to like technology dehancements.
Especially the website families.
Yeah, you gotta stop hanging out with those Amish.
Yeah.
Like I think they got you.
Too techie.
So I have a question about my own personal technology use. Because, obviously it's going to be difficult to just go cold turkey and get rid of everything.
Yeah, but for sure.
Surely, I can still bring my phone in the shower because I got to be able to count my steps.
Oh, my God. The shower is the worst place for the phone because, forget electrocution. Like, the phone waves merge with water, and then that just seeps into your brain.
You think hives are bad? Like, you'll just see holes.
Well,
wow.
He gets most of the steps in the shower.
Ty, I gotta ask real quick. I'm sorry to interrupt. Is that something that you have seen in the past, maybe recently?
Unfortunately.
Oh, man.
My roommate, former, I kicked him out, left his phone in the shower. I took a shower, passed out, and I woke up with just lesions and holes, all over. I look like a block of Swiss cheese.
That's a level 4 brain seep.
Let me get to that chapter here. Level 4.
That's chapter 18?
Yeah. Level 4 brain seep. Okay. You have a lot of illustrations for this one.
There's a lot of...
Yeah.
Where did you guys get this information? Is this from your testing and findings? Or did you talk to any scientists? Or?
Yeah. This is all personally, experimentally run by the both of us in double-blind clinical trials.
Yeah. It's just both of my eyes.
Oh, right.
Yeah, we just took out his eyes so we can, analogly see what's going on without using a computer. Because we didn't want to harm ourselves in the process of this trials.
Yeah, right.
To analogly see. Is that another term for in person again? I'm just trying to track to make sure the audience can track.
Yeah, thank you for doing that. Because, this terminology, I'm Gen Z, very easy to follow along. But, for most viewers, it's probably not.
Yeah, that's a good point. How much are you selling this book for now?
Right.
$19.99.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very reasonably priced.
Okay, so...
Does it have an ebook version? Can I get it on my Kindle?
And just print out the coupons?
Yeah, the ebook version is $500.
Okay.
Oh,
so we'll...
wow.
So nobody's going to get it. Oh, Kyler, you're so smart.
Yeah, some people love technology, so we have to give them the option. It'd be a marketing stupid move not to do that, but... We don't want people to get it digitally, so.
Okay, so.
I'm sold on this, Dr. London. I mean, I know you guys haven't asked, but I would love to put the Jock Doc seal of approval on this book.
Oh my God, thank you so much.
Put our sticker right
huge.
There on the cover.
Yeah.
It tastes just like that. Okay.
And Crampy Koala is going to have to be, a picture of the koala is going to have to be on the book if we're endorsing it. And you guys are going to have to be a subsidiary now of Koala Cola, the number one cola in Australia.
According to them, yes.
Cola's been around for a while. Australia's been around for a while. I've never seen a koala use an iPhone. I don't see any problem.
Perfect. Okay, I think we're... So, to our listeners, if you want a 500-page book of Kyler here doing experiments on Ty... which is mostly what it is. Just pick it up anywhere.
Yeah.
Wait, how did they get it?
Is it because you didn't trust anyone?
They probably
to ship
can't
it.
Just like, yeah, they probably can't order it on Amazon or anything.
Just
right?
go to a local bookstore, or your library, or
and you're there.
Oh, it, It's stocked up in bookstores and libraries.
Yeah, like,
or are you outside?
Yeah, we put them there.
Okay, you donated them. For
no. We just like took out some of the C++ for Dummies books and replaced them.
At all the nation's bookstores.
Yeah, Barnes and Nobles, Borders, mom and pop bookshop.
Yeah.
Those
you
three.
Hit all of them.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
Everything.
Yeah, like five. All of them.
Great. Now I hate to move on, but I feel like we've covered enough to obviously to get the Jock Doc podcast app of approval and the Koala Cola approval. So we kind of, and I feel awkward asking this, but would you two mind helping us with the chores? We have some chores to do.
Sure.
Great. Chores are great.
Yeah, we're here to help people.
Okay. Cameron, you want to explain what the chore wheel is?
So basically Dr. London and I had neglected everything on our to-do list for a really long time. There was just a lot on TV. There was just a lot going on, but because of it, we haven't gotten to any of our chores. We haven't done the dishes. We haven't taken out the trash. We haven't fed any of the horses, and we haven't fed any of the horses' horses. And so all of these things have just been sort of piling up. So we built this fun chore wheel that we spin every single week. Whatever it lands on, whatever task it is, we have to do it.
So could both of you, lend a hand on spinning the chore wheel? Because it is kind of massive, and we have not oiled it. So it's very rusty.
Oh, wow. Wow, this, I thought this is huge.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's gotten bigger.
It's most of the building at this point, I would say.
How long have you been, doing this wheel thing again? Yeah. Since, how long?
Well, so every week we do destroy it. So it's a new wheel every week because we have more chores and we finish one chore.
Well, let me think. I think when we started, Girlfriend by Avril Lavigne was on the radio a lot.
I don't know what that is.
So that's... Oof.
Avril Lavigne is a singer.
Avril Lavigne is so she's a millennial, which I know your generation is not going to know about. But anyway, she died in a car accident and was replaced by a clone that looks exactly like her. And she's singing a song called Girlfriend.
Also, the clone is just as talented, I think.
I think even more talented than the original Avril.
That's hard to pull off. I'm not as good as my original.
Oh, that's sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of questions I want to get into that. Unfortunately, we have to get to these chores, but I mean, what can I just ask real quick? What version of this copy are you?
Oh, it's just my right arm. It got too infested with lesions from the shower, 5G water, so.
And
it just doesn't work as well.
Oh, so you're saying the original version, the pre-lesion version of yourself. That makes sense. Okay.
Before you fell ill to whatever caused. Yes, okay.
And now he has become what he fears the most. It's a tragic story. Part technology.
Oh, because he's part cyborg at this point. Yes. Okay. Well, and I'm sorry to really be pushy about this, but would you two mind just, it's so rusty that it does take at least two, and then I'll pull this chain to try to get it going.
Dude, bro.
Okay. Okay, so, it landed on...
Ooh, I knew we were going to have to do this one eventually.
Ugh. I hate this one. But we have to do
it. We got it. What is it?
Okay. Yeah. So this was the city council has been on to us. They need this. They've been giving tours of the city and tours of different, municipalities, these walking tours to try to increase tourism. And so one of the tours they want to give is the happy place you go into in your mind. And they want us to help with that, to give sort of an example tour. The tours that of the happy places that each of us go to in our minds. So
the chore, okay, the chore is giving a tour of the happy places each of us individually go to
in our minds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got it.
Simple. Hard to believe that anyone could confuse that one. That's so simple. Yeah.
And we're just going to get this recording, and then this is going to be part of the
tour.
Tour. They're just going to listen to an audio of us describing it.
Well, it's just so they know what to do.
Oh, because okay. When they're
so
in
many
there.
People try to go to the happy place in their mind, and then they're like, they just have no idea what that means, what that is.
Do we have like one collective mind, or is it like four minds?
No, I know I have mine.
Yeah, I mean, do you want to talk about the happy place in my mind? Give it a quick tour. It's not long.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, you can go first. Yeah.
Yeah, so mine is obviously the city of Cleveland, Ohio. The city of Cleveland, Ohio exists, I believe, mostly in my mind.
Right.
And so, honestly, I would say any sort of information that you can get on that city is going to be really helpful when you're in there. So yeah, I would recommend Google Maps. I would recommend maybe even checking out like diners, drive-ins, and dives just to see like some good places to eat.
So you're recommending referral, basically.
Yeah, like go see a Reds game. Like, there's just so much you can do. Or wait, Indians game. Just one of those is a baseball thing.
Yeah, okay. The Drew Carey Show is what I
Drew Carey Show. And so,
what? It's not filmed now. It's over. Yeah, okay. Great. So that was a fantastic example. Let's see, Kyler, do you want to share sort of the happy place you go to in your mind to, I guess, relax or just to find the happy place?
So, you know, as you know, I'm like so conflicted on like, you know, technology is bad, but I'm like Gen Z, so I like have to use technology all the time. So like my happy place is just like sitting in a meadow under a tree, but like documenting all of it on TikTok, Instagram, and Bloofer. It's like a new social media. You probably never heard of it because you're not Gen Z.
Okay.
Is
it like House Club?
Well, it was weird. I don't know if this happened to you, Dr. London, but when you said whatever that word was, it just sort of sounded like static.
Yeah.
What was it called again?
Bloofer?
It's like that word. It's like like a dog whistle or something. Like I can't even hear the frequency of it.
Is that a Gen Z or Jed Zen thing where it comes out as a dog whistle?
I think that's
yeah.
Sounds about right.
Unfortunately, this is covered in chapter 34 where there's just words you can't hear anymore as you get older because the technology just goes over your head, even verbally. It's insane.
Oh. Wow. Yeah. I understand that the concept of not being able to, you know, put a definition to a word or for the word to be foreign, but for the word to be so foreign that it doesn't even, you know, come to you intelligibly. That's new to me, but I guess I'm getting older. All right, Ty, how about your happy place?
Yeah. My happy place is obviously devoid of technology. It's just like,
so is that like a hole?
It's like a hole, but like it's like I'm naked, you know, and
all the technology of clothing,
just water, is just pouring all over me, and it's just like I don't know where the water begins and my skin ends, so I'm just one with this water. You know?
Yeah, pretty lukewarm. And
you're skinny dipping in a lake, essentially.
Yeah, but like nothing that glamorous. Just me floating. I don't it's just me floating and no pictures, no cameras. That's just me float. I don't even know where I am because if I knew, you know, people are gonna start the tagging and the following, so I don't even know because I am sure my right arm with its technology we'll just read the brainwaves and tell everybody where I am. It's not what I want. I just wake up and I don't know where I am. That's my happy place.
Ty, do you go to float tanks ever?
Float tanks?
Yeah. Do you ever go inside of a building and then someone ushers you into sort of a tank, like a sensory deprivation tank that then you float in?
Yeah. Kyler put me in one of those, and when I woke up, like, it was 3 months later.
Yeah, that's in chapter 42. Oh.
Yeah, that was pretty wild. Like, I'm like a human pickle with all that salt water, but it's worth it.
So 3 months. So you met, okay. I'm just trying to get the timeline down of, because you guys, it wasn't that long ago that you guys met.
You met on Black Friday. And you had to write the book. Wrote the book. At least 3 months of the book was, but it sounds like Kyler documented the whole experience of the 3 months you were in this float.
Yeah. Track.
But yeah, I mean, it sounds like your happy place is maybe some sort of lingering trauma from being stuck in a float tank for 3 months.
To be honest, if you ask me right now, what are your scariest memories or anything, I would be thinking about that.
I mean, that's awesome. Yeah, I think the mayor and the city council is really, really going to like that.
Yeah. Oh, that's really kind of what they were hinting at, I think. So mine's a little bit similar in that, you know, for me, it's also skinny dipping, but it's a lot of, you know, crowds watching and taking pictures and a lot of flash photography. And I don't like that, but I like having some attention, but I'm very I kind of walk this line. My happy place is this line between, you know, fame and extreme discomfort.
Fame and shame.
Fame and shame. Yeah. So
that's a good chapter.
I'm unintentionally skinny dipping. I should add that.
Oh, are you adding this to the book right now? You just said that's a good chapter.
Fame and shame. Fame and shame.
Yeah, I mean, I'm fine with, if the book is ever expanding, I am fine with that. That's awesome.
Tinder's gonna.
Well,
ruin
you're fine
her.
With that because it's not you.
Yeah.
Hold on. It's me. So it's.
Yeah, but then now you're immortalized in a book. It sounds like Dr. London.
Yeah, that's
carried in all five bookstores nationwide.
Yeah, we're gonna update the books tomorrow. Just like run around and like swap in the chapter.
Yeah, we got five sheets of paper somewhere.
Chapter 47. There it is. After the coupons.
Yeah. You're just going to stuff the pages in there. Yeah, that I feel like that would work. So, I mean, Dr. London, how are you feeling in the, I mean, you're saying it's just this place of fame and shame?
Yeah, so the context of this skinny dipping is important because I am like fully dressed walking along a dock at night and I think I'm alone, and then I get tricked by a little creature, like it's not a mermaid, but it's like a fish thing saying like, well, you know, hop in, oh, but you know, we don't allow any of the external whatever.
Yeah,
so I and, you know, yeah, take off
it's not
clothes.
A mermaid, but you listen to the little fish thing, you take off your clothes anyway.
Well, I know mermaids can be treacherous. I saw that one Pirates of the Caribbean movie where they're mean.
It might be a catfish.
So I knew to.
Ooh, I've heard about these from
you
earlier.
Yeah. So
did it look like an older person trying to be Zach Braff? Because those are the ones you got to look out for.
Those you have to look out for. Yeah.
It's one of those. So my happy place is when an old guy who looks kind of like Zach Braff. Tricks me into stripping naked and jumping in the water at night with a lot of documentation happening.
In a sort of human zoo.
Yes, that's... I'm wondering... this is so vivid in my mind right now. I feel like... like maybe I've... is this my happy place?
Or is this from a past life?
Or just my regular... I mean, in this context, I'm imagining it was scrubs that I was taking off.
And do you, how, like, Do you go to sleep to go to this place, or is this just something that happens on weekends?
Well, yeah. Well, every Friday.
Okay. Yeah. When you famously drive out to the quarry.
That's right.
Yeah.
I feel like I don't, especially now they know it's Fridays. Anyway, maybe city council, if you could, not include that part, the scheduling
it's
aspect.
It's all in. It's all live,
yeah,
Dr.
You just
London.
Doxed yourself.
Yeah, that's...
I'm sorry, guys. We can't take... It's live right now. We can't take it back. Yes, Dr. London goes down to the quarry every single Friday. I'm sorry to dox you.
I'll check it out, man. I'll go there with my friend Chris.
Okay. Well, I feel like that's... So we finished the chore. That's that much at least we can...
All right, check it off.
Yeah, and let's go ahead and... So we are going to have to just knock this over because I don't think there's a way to physically destroy it at this point. It's too strong. But we can, just push the whole thing and then maybe use it as a foundation for a house, this chore wheel.
Do you want to use a pulley system? Ty said that was okay. We won't get legions from that.
That's fine.
Up
to three bends.
Okay, so let's use the three bends. Okay. So we'll throw that up there. Okay.
Nice.
Loop
nice.
It through.
Nice throw.
All right. All right. And we're all okay. We all take a hand. Okay. And okay. Oh no. There's someone under.
Oh. Wait. Was that a catfish?
I think it was like Zach Braff, like the real one.
Oh shit.
He was coming to kick my ass.
That's a good way to let's just maybe stop this here. Thank you to our
thank you to
Kyler and Ty. Do you have anything to promote? Well, obviously your book. What was the name of your book again? Did we say the detrimental
health effects of technology on your health.
Oh. Okay.
We wanted health to be in there twice just to remind people.
They might forget, by the end of that.
Yeah, these short attention spans of these Gen Zs just require you to repeat everything.
These kids.
I'm sorry. It's just like how we were born.
Okay.
No, I get it. You've got your phones. I mean.
Yeah. So is there anything else that you'd like to promote? Any friends of yours that are doing anything?
There's these two guys that Kyler keeps on talking about who are on this Twitter talk,
there's this like streaming platform called Twitch. If I'm going too fast, like please stop me. There's a streaming platform called Twitch, and there are these
I guess Twitch is the part that gets me because we're on a streaming platform now.
Right. So like Twitch is like it streams video and you can like chat using emotes. It's like crazy.
So Twitch is sort of like the video version of Koala Cola live stream audio only.com.
Yes. All of those words put together. And then, there's these two guys named Kent and Farshad and they have like this really cool show. I normally record it on like a cassette tape so I can like give it to Ty over there.
Or a wax cylinder. I like those.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. How do people find this?
So they just go on www.twitch.tv/Kent K-E-N-T Farshad, Farshad. It's like an ethnic name. I'm ethnic, so I can say that.
I think they sound Amish.
Yeah, they just like bring on really cool guests, and they just like talk about the state of like comedy because I love laughing.
Okay, great. And you know what? Sometimes, not most of the time, but sometimes I also enjoy laughing. So. That sounds like something worth checking out. Okay.
That's good. That's good. Laughter is the real medicine. Don't trust these tech people.
Yeah, the phones and all that. Okay. Yeah. Thank you to producer Cameron, especially for setting up the streaming thing. And I'm glad that we finally went such a long time without pauses or, you know, skipping back and forth.
Oh, that's just, yeah. The listenership has been at zero. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's
just like my shower session.
Yeah.
Yeah, except I don't think anyone is, you know, passing out and waking up with, you know, holes. Anyway, we don't need to go into all
that. Yeah, and so thank you to Digital in the House.
You at least swore the oath.
Yeah, the QAnon oath.
The QAnon oath.
Meeting people through the internet is dangerous.
The QAnon oath.
The QAnon oath.
You know, even I wouldn't dare to do that. Some people online do catfishing. Have you heard of catfishing?
Like, the older you are, the more analog you are. And the more analog you are, you're more my homie.
Meeting people through the internet is dangerous.
My name is Dr. London Smith.com, and this has been the Jock Doc Podcast.
See ya.